fangs that go bump in the night.
What the? Jesus!
Me.
Jerk.
Sandy.
Okay.
Shrunken head, broken legs, body parts on the concrete. Cut them up, butcher style gators in the swamp. Red light, leave them dead, running like a track meet. Scared of nobody, what
you know who I am?
Swamp.
You have any idea who you're fucking talking to? Or maybe you saw me in the playoff. I played for the fucking goddamn champions.
Well, fair, cooking meat, cannibal, trying to eat. I got a zombie on me, and you can't harm me.
Hey, watch
who
it.
Do you voodoo, bitch? Drink blood like a vampire without warning. Who do you voodoo, bitch? Stand up. Sam B got the thing that go bump in the night.
Whoa.
Who do you voodoo, bitch? Hide your kids, grab your wife, better get out of sight.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Let's go. Sam B to Papa Shango, I'm Baron Samedi. Handful of fingertips, toss them up like confetti. Stay full of corpse bitches, I'm a pimp of the dead. Come fuck with a
another
zombie,
drunk
I put a stake in your head.
God's
look, you want ghouls, I got fucking
school. Get-
Maybe everybody dies, I'll see your ass real soon. Crack bones to the mirror, hot sauce, and they suck it. Now my juju ain't nothing to fuck.
Sir, looks like you've had enough. What's your room number? I'll make sure you get there safe and sound.
That go bump in the night.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Hide your kids, grab your wife, better get out of sight.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Let's go!
Excuse me, lady. Are you okay? Can you hear me? What are you doing, sir? This is the woman's restroom.
I got a zombie on Sandy. You can't harm me.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Excuse me, sir. Are you okay?
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Arms off of my bare hand.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
Yeah. Smack it, mama.
Who do you voodoo, bitch?
I grew up in New Orleans, Lower Ninth Ward. My daddy went to prison when I was 2, and that's where he died, Angola. Mama didn't ever recover from that. Just drank and did crack, and any random motherfucker who didn't smack her around too bad. My nana the one who raised me. She run the Walsh Interior. We lived in a little shotgun house on Burgundy. From the time I was 10, man, I wanted to rap. I was into old school freestyle rap, and I'd be kicking ass at them battles, bro. But man, just couldn't catch a break. Nothing caught on. So, one Halloween, I come up with, "Who do you voodoo, bitch?" Just as a motherfucking joke, you know? We right to the top of the hip hop charts like a motherfucking rocket. And suddenly, I was famous. Going to the Grammys, hitting the parties. Man, I had bitches up to yin yang. And for the first time in my life, I was making money. I was spending it as quick as I was getting it. I thought I'd made it, you know what I'm saying? That gravy train wasn't there going in. So I did another song, and another song. Nothing hit. Nothing fucking hit. Song after song, and ain't nobody give a shit. Been 10 years, man. Yeah, I can still get gigs, but all they want me to do is, "Who do you voodoo, bitch?" I used to play the big casinos in Vegas or Atlanta City. Now it's just Reno or Laughlin. Some motherfucking crew shit. So this gig here might be my last chance. I mean, there's some heavy Hollywood hitters up in there. If I could notice, yeah, I could be right back up on top there. You know what I'm saying? got here?
Emergency broadcast system. Please leave your apartment immediately. Follow signs to the nearest staircase. For safety reasons, all elevators are offline. Please remain calm and follow the instructions. This is Hotel Emergency Broadcast System. Please leave your apartment immediately. Follow signs to the nearest staircase. For safety reasons, all elevators are offline.
Can't hurt to take a look.
Through the camera. Feeling all right, mate? The shakes? Fever? Chills? Good. I'll introduce myself later. Right now, we gotta get you the hell out of there. Do exactly as I say, okay? You're gonna have to trust me. First, you need to get hold of a weapon. Search in the maintenance storage room by the end of the corridor. I would move if I were you. Now.
Let's hope there's something useful.
said no. You heard what he said. Do you hear what's going on out there? You want what you got here?
I'm doing it.
No!
Didn't my buddy tell you?
Now stop! Wait!
Hey! Can you hear me? Do you understand what I'm saying? Nod your head! Nod your bloody head!
I ain't asking you again! Oh, thank God. I'm a doctor, not a bloody executioner.
Do you know how close we came to bashing your head in?
Those things came for us, and Cedamoy went out to kill them alone.
There's nothing to fucking do.
Help him.
He's dead.
Why won't anyone help him? You can't just let him die out there. He saved your life. You owe him your life.
Going out there? Are you nuts?
You're not gonna help. Get the hell out of the way.
You at least have a weapon? You need to find a weapon.
Why won't anyone do anything?
All right. This is fucking crazy. On three. One, two, fuck it, three!
One? Okay then. Thanks, mates.
Are you there? Hello? Can you hear me? Shit. Hello?
We were just attacked. Listen, your friend from the hotel's awake. You were right about him being immune to this thing. If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have made it. Maybe now we can hold out until help arrives.
There is no help. This thing can't be stopped. I saw how it took my wife.
You need to get out of there, and I can help you. I can arrange for transportation. By air, by sea, but first you need to get here. To me.
I have many sick and injured here, mate. They're crazy with fear. Tell me where you are. Where are you? You there, mate? Hello? Hello? Oh, God damn it. We didn't think you were gonna make it.
Kill them all.
Getting the hang of this.
I didn't see you out there.
Name's John Cinnamoy. I'm the head lifeguard here. The voice on the radio told me you were in trouble at the hotel. Said you were resistant to whatever this is. I didn't believe it, but then I found you and I saw the bite marks. You got no symptoms, but those aren't love bites, are they? Look, I don't know who you are or how you know that guy on the radio, but he's our only connection with the outside world. We keep losing the bloody signal. We have a monsoon coming. So here's the thing. We need to move everybody to the main lifeguard station. There's an ambulance there and more equipment and a stronger radio with an antenna.
To you.
I hate to ask, but we can't do this without you. Will you help me?
Aye.
Good. First off, we need an access card to get past the security gate. Mine's in my room. With all the commotion, I forgot to take it with. It's in Bungalow 11, by the pools. Take a weapon and watch yourself. You may be immune. That don't mean you can't die.
This is the end of day.
Why the hell did I stay here with Cinnamoy? I should have listened to Maggie and left with James and the others. They probably found a way off the island by now. Maybe there's still time to find them. If you're out there and you see Maggie and the others, could you let me know where they are?
I'ma try.
Thanks. I'll be here. Because, I mean, you know, where the hell else am I gonna go?
It's in the Book of Revelations.
You kill them
all? Thank God we found you.
Jesus Christ, man! Something new to fight with.
Thank you.
This is Roger Howard on a special assignment on the island of Banui. I'm investigating illegal logging and clear-cutting that's not only damaging the ecosystem here, but costing the people of Banui billions. I've been told that my life might be in danger as those behind this illegal activity will stop at nothing to protect their criminal enterprise. As a precaution, I will be leaving a trail of recordings wherever I go, so that if something were to happen to me, the truth could still be told. I'm leaving now to meet with an informant who I believe could rip the lid off of this investigation.
I do. My wife. My dad. Oh, fuck. My own fucking brother. Jesus Christ. What else could I do? Let him kill me? Why are you looking at me like that? What the fuck do you want from me? I had no choice.
Oh. Ah.
and don't want to pass up anything useful.
Looking like a motherfucking postcard.
Thank God we found you. You did it? All right. Thanks to you, we might all just make it. Okay, you ready to go out there again? I need you to find a lifeguard station and see if it's safe. Can you do that for me?
Uh-huh.
Take the beach. It's the shortest way. We'll come as soon as we know it's safe. There should be a working radio inside. Signal us when it's clear, and we'll follow you.
You kill them all?
What's in here? You ain't giving me a choice here!
Oh, fuck! Fuck! Jesus Christ. If you hadn't come along.
You want to come with me? I'm gathering any supplies I can find at the water sports rental kiosk. Maybe you'll find something that'll come in handy.
is fucking insane. Shape. Maybe there's something in here.
He's likely got rabies or something.
Hang it is.
Nice. Job, mates. We're safe now, thanks to you. But we won't make it long without food. Help don't come soon. We're gonna have to head to town. Meantime, maybe you could see if anybody needs help.
Somebody help me with this blood. Hey, remember me, mate? I'm the doctor, but I can't do much without medical supplies. The door to the infirmary is locked from the other side, and Anne's in critical condition. You think you can help me break the bloody thing down?
I'm here.
I appreciate it. Go on, then. Good on you, mate. Now let me get to work.
There's nothing. No bandages, no antibiotics, no pain.
Kelly's worried about her husband, Will, but I think he's probably okay. If you happen to be nearby there, can you see if you can find him?
Yeah.
His name is William. He's about 6'1", black hair, good looking. He's a concierge. He has a friend named Doyle who works in the Diamond District bungalows. I'm thinking maybe he's hiding out there.
You don't want to pass up anything useful.
Me, please. Please. I need your help. I don't understand any of this. Please, my husband, he's bleeding. Can you help us?
Let's see what we got. Getting good at this.
What is happening here?
We need help! Before more of them come! Name's Roger, brothers. And this is my wife, Jess. We were driving like a bat out of hell when I saw that broke down car. Part of me said, forget about it! But I couldn't do that and live with myself, so we stopped to see if we could help. The driver must have been in shock or something because he threw himself at us like a crazy guy. I had to kill him. But this was self-defense. I was protecting myself. You gotta believe me. But you know what? He took a bite out of me, man. Shit. I think I got whatever he had. Rabies. I don't know. Fuck. Who the hell knows? But can you get Jess out of here? If I start to lose it, I don't want to bloody hurt her.
I'ma try.
Hey, man. Thanks. should take her to the lighthouse. My brother James should be there. He'll take her in.
There are people living in the lighthouse?
Can't be.
Where the hell did I put that?
I can't believe you're alive. When we left Sinamoy, you looked like Jesus. Anyway, you better go see.
Anything good in here?
I'm sure I'll be surprised as hell to see you still alive. James will probably want to talk to you first. James is at the top of the lighthouse. Go see him.
Holy shit, you're alive? We saw.
I'm James. You don't know me, but I shall remember you. Me and Sinamoy had a slight difference of opinion. He wanted to stay put and wait for help. I wanted to get the hell out of there. So I got the hell out. Now, we're working on setting up the lighthouse to signal for assistance. We sure could use your help.
Yeah.
Now, if you want to get off this island with the rest of us, go talk to my people. See what you can do to help, okay?
We need to talk. Unlike Sinamoy and his crew, we're not content to sit in our butts and hope that help's on its way. We're more proactive, you know? Farther up the coast, there's a couple shipwrecks. The result of that monsoon that came through. I'm thinking they might have supplies, including signal flares. help finally does get here, like maybe the military, we need a way to let them know where we are. You interested in a little salvage work?
I'm up for it.
Good. And when the help finally does get here, and we get their attention, I guarantee a first spot on the chopper.
What the hell? We followed James to this lighthouse so we could send out an SOS signal using the lamp. But there's something wrong with the power. Marcus went to check the two transformers powering the lighthouse, but he's been gone for hours. Someone needs to see what's happened to him and try to get the power back on. Those things can't do to you what they can do to us. Maybe you can help us.
Aye.
All right, good. The transformers are in the northern part of the Gold Bungalow area. If you can get the power back on, I'll let you into the storage shed. I'm Darvin, by the way.
Can't get through.
Where the hell did I put that?
Thank you. Can you check on my husband?
Thank you. This baby needs some new spark plugs or she ain't going nowhere. Shame, though. It's a hell of a car. A battalion of those freaks wouldn't slow this baby down. So, if you can find me a few necessary parts from any nearby wrecked cars, and we get this ride rolling, I'll let you take her out anytime you want. Deal?
Yeah.
Excellent. You locate those parts. You know where to find me. Whoa, great job. Nice. Now just give me a sec and I'll get this bitch running.
Before they start attracting more of these walking dead motherfuckers. Do me a favor. See if you can't get some gas from that station nearby.
I'm up for it.
Okay, good. See if you can find a car. That way you can move more gas.
I'm so thirsty.
I'm safe in here. Dehydrated. The monsters can't get me. Who are you?
I'm Annie, and I'm looking for my teddy bear. I can't fall asleep without him, and I'm very tired. And those monsters keep knocking. Will you find my teddy bear?
Let's do it.
The last time I saw him, he was in our bungalow, number 15, where I live with my sister Jenny. Remember, his name is Teddy. Tell him Annie sent you, and I'm sure he'll go with you. He's a brave teddy bear.
I feel dizzy and a little nauseous. My heart is pounding, please. I haven't had anything to drink for quite a while. If you bring me some water, I'll give you whatever I have.
I'm up for it.
Oh, thank God. Thank you. Whatever you can find. Oh, thank God. Thank you.
Teddy will protect me.
Oh!
police. You gotta take this insulin to my brother, Danny. He needs it. He's in bungalow 14. Please.
Yeah.
Good. Look, you better go. He's running out of time.
I'm so sorry, Tim. I'm so sorry. You weren't you. I didn't know what else to do. Jesus Christ! Timmy! I'm so sorry, Tim. I'm so sorry.
What we got here?
Hey, you! Go over to the door! Give me a sec to open it.
What, you want gas? Sorry, the pumps ain't working. Power's out and the generator's in the warehouse next door. Unfortunately, the front entrance is blocked. You know, maybe there's another way in. Try the roof. That might work. Head out the back so they don't see you, and take some canisters with. Yo, once you get in, turn on the power and refuel those canisters. Now that we're here, we're not moving anywhere. It's too friggin' dangerous out there.
Busted up!